G'day guys, Bjorn here from Weeks of Macklin Real Estate with tips on how to choose the best agent for you. Let's get stuck straight into it. Number one, communication. Communication is the foundation of everything that is successful in life, whether it be relationships, friendships, or business models. Make sure your agent has the highest levels of communication. They communicate through SMS, phone call, and email on a rapid basis, on a regular basis. Two, sales plan. Do they actually have a plan on how to handle the sale of your property? Or do they just simply put a signboard out the front and put it on the internet and sit and wait for things to happen? What is their sales plan from start to finish and everything in between? Three, local knowledge. You need to be dealing with an agent that has a local understanding of your area, because buyers are going to be asking them questions about the area, and if they can't answer those questions, they're going to basically look like an idiot. So make sure they have good local knowledge of your area as well as your property. Four, sales negotiation skills. This is very important. Ask them to go through some role plays with you. How do they handle objections? How do they handle their sales? How do they negotiate with buyers? Number five, presentation. You need an agent that is well presented. You can't have an agent rocking up to an open inspection in thongs and a t-shirt. Okay, we're in a professional business, professional game. The agent needs to look professional. Number six, marketing quality. Ask them to show you examples of the marketing that they conducted for other properties that they've sold in the past. Marketing is a very, very, very important factor when you're selling your property. You do not want to be stuck with an agent who prints brochures off their own printer in-house and takes their own photos with their iPhone and puts the property up on realestate.com or domain on page 5 to begin with. Premium quality marketing is premium price. Remember that, guys. Now, efficiency. You need an agent that's efficient. Ask agents for information. Can you send me a report in my area? See how long it takes for them to get back in touch with you. Okay, you need someone who delivers accurate information efficiently. Average days on market. Every single agent out there should know what their average days on market is, so simply ask them. Are they a team or individual? There are a lot of agents out there running around in teams, and there are also a lot of agents, more so, that are running around as individuals. There's a lot of work involved in real estate, guys. There's a lot of administration work, a lot of marketing work, a lot of preparation work. The sale that you guys see is only 10%, the tip of the iceberg. So, do they have a team to help them with all those mundane tasks so they can be out on the road listing and selling properties, which is helping you getting your property sold for a premium price in the shortest possible time? Or are they stuck behind a desk in the office doing administrative tasks that could be handed on to somebody else? Very important. I think individuals, thing of the past, you need to be going for agents that work in teams these days. And number 10, what is their referral rate of business? Every good agent out there should know where their leads are coming from, where their listings are coming from, where their sales are coming from. And the agents that are the best performing agents in my eyes are those which have the highest rate of referral business. If they're getting referred clients from past clients that they've helped, that they've made promises to and delivered upon, and then they're recommending them to friends and family, they must be doing something right. Another factor, very quickly, there are plenty of websites out there where you can get research nowadays, guys. I'm going to go through some really good ones, and I'm going to go through one which is an absolute shocker. Okay? Firstly, www.ratemyagent.com.au. This website will give you referrals from past customers. If you are thinking about employing an agent, don't do anything until you check out what other clients have to say about them. This is a third-party website. It's got nothing to do with me. I do not own it. I'm not promoting it for any reason other than the fact that I have good referral rate of business and I have good positive feedback from my clients, and I want you guys to go and check it out at ratemyagent.com.au. If you're looking for property reports, two good websites, www.homeguru.com.au, instant delivery to your inbox via email, sales in your area. www.ozhomevalues.com.au, a fantastic website also. Now, you may have heard of Open Agent and you've heard it advertised on TV, and they claim to find you the best agent for the sale of your property. I want to tell you guys about how that works. It is the worst website out there. They are not finding you the best agent for the sale of your property. I'll tell you guys exactly how it works now. The way that website works, if you're a real estate agent, you give them 30% of your commission in order for them to refer you properties. So that is not what I call a proper referral rate business. This is people buying your business. In order to do that, in order to pay Open Agent the 30% that's required, they need to charge you a higher fee to cover that cost. I hope that's good information for you guys. Have a fantastic weekend, and I'll see you out there. Bye for now.